Hey everyone, filming this way this time. Camera seems a little bit better at the moment, but yeah, I just wanted to film an update because I heard from my endocrinologist a couple days ago. I was gonna do a video and then I just kind of delayed it, so here I am now. My diagnosis has kind of switched. I have thyroiditis, that is the diagnosis. I'm reading a little bit about it, and basically it's kind of like a three-stage thing. She kind of told me a little bit about it too. Basically it starts with the hyperthyroidism, so that's why she thought I had Graves. So basically your thyroid gland is like producing way too much of a certain hormone, causes your to be hyperthyroidism, and then you go through a switch and it switches to hypothyroidism. So a slow thyroid. So I don't know if I'm in that yet or if I'm going to be approaching that. I have to get blood work at the end of the month to kind of see where I'm at with that. Basically, I kind of asked her about whether she thought maybe this could be related to Lyme disease. And she went, huh, you know what? I think I actually had a patient that I did a paper on in 2019. A man who had Lyme disease and then developed thyroiditis. So she's like, oh, I think you might be onto something there. So I don't really have like a lot of answers yet, just kind of that this is thyroiditis and I have a good feeling that it's probably related to the Lyme disease. Basically means that the Lyme disease is a chronic condition for me. It's not just, Lyme disease is very complicated. Actually, I'm gonna show you because I went to the library the other day and I got a couple books. So this one is a memoir. She has Lyme disease. Started it, but so far, really loving it. She's like talking about being like really dismissed by doctors in the hospital and healthcare workers, and basically people don't believe her and all this kind of stuff. But she had chronic Lyme disease. Interested in this so far. Just, I'm trying to be my own advocate at this point. And I also found this about cannabis for Lyme disease, which I'm really enjoying. I want to, again, like I'm trying to educate myself. I'm tired of having mental health, especially like shaming me and making me feel like I'm an addict for using cannabis. But I'm just going to like read a little bit out of this, just a couple little spots where that I was kind of like, found it interesting. So first little foreword. Lyme disease is a pathogen of sophisticated stealthiness, meaning the spirochete bacteria that causes Lyme disease is able to sequester itself inside host cells to avoid the immune system's detection. These bacteria affect a variety of body organs, tissues, cells, and glands. The symptoms they create in the body have led to calling Lyme disease the great imitator, for it mimics MS, fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, heart disease, irritable bowel syndrome, metabolic diseases, and psychotic episodes. Lyme is really crazy, you guys. Like, I don't know, doctors don't really understand it. They thought it was like just like this made up thing, like that hypochondriacs had for a long time, but it's a real thing. And I suffer from this. And I had a feeling that I was probably going to be a chronic Lyme sufferer just from everything that I've been going through. And I'm, you know, with, you know, fibromyalgia and stuff like that, I'm kind of correlating everything to that. I'm just learning, but trying to, again, be my own advocate, learn more about Lyme disease and what I can kind of do for it. I mean, I'd like to be able to have a doctor that, you know, can help me, but we'll see. I will say that the endocrinologist, when she called, she was very, very nice this time around. She apologized to me for taking too long to get back to me, and she listened to me and agreed with my belief on what this could be. It's going to be a long road, a journey, and I'm not really sure, you know, what is going to happen, but I have a little bit more answer now. No, it's thyroiditis. Oh, and I was able to stop my methimazole, which is the thyroid med that they had me on, because she said it's not gonna do anything because you're not, you don't have Graves' disease, you don't have hyperthyroidism now. And I'm also going down on my beta blocker again. So I'm at 5 milligrams now, which is good. I'm happy to be, you know, getting off some of these meds. I even deleted the med tracker from my phone, which I'm so happy about, because it was just a lot of remembering to take pills and all that kind of stuff. So I might end up on a different medication at some point, especially if I go into hypothyroidism, which seems to be that's going to be my next state. It does say that you can go into, I can't remember the name of it, but it's like basically your thyroid levels will level out and can resolve themselves. So hopefully that'll happen for me, but who knows what other health concerns are going to come up in the future, especially if it's chronic Lyme disease. All I can say is just don't mess with ticks, you guys. I don't even remember getting bit by a tick. So yeah, I just ended up with the rashes. That's kind of my update. Thyroiditis, that's my diagnosis for there. Believe it's Lyme disease related. Don't totally know yet. Yeah. More blood work at the end of the month. And then I talked to her on the 27th. So